Oh wow, look how low I have fallen. Now I'm making first impression videos, and the first show I chose to go over is trash right from the cover. Everybody looks like 7 years old when in reality they are at least twice as old. Why bother to make them seem older when this way they look cuter for the girls and lolier for the neckbeards? Remember the effort they used to put into the artwork back in the 80s? God damn it, do I miss it! First minute and the protagonist is hungry and weak. That doesn't stop him from saving a girl which was falling from a high place. How high was that spot that girl was falling from? He had enough time to listen her screaming, see where she was, get up, transform, run, and still capture her in the air while holding a huge heavy lance that has no purpose holding at that moment. Totally not done to show double standards so the audience can both sympathize and find him cool. It might have worked too if he didn't look like he's 7 years old. Second minute is the opening song, and it shows a little naked girl. That is what you will be seeing every time an episode begins, a little naked girl.
Totally family material.
Third minute is the rest of the opening song. It's just the same girl crying non-stop until a blonde angel comes to take her away or something. Who the hell would find interesting an opening of a girl who is not a protagonist, doing nothing but crying for a hero to come and save her?
The otakus who self-insert as him.
Fourth minute and the episode begins with a long info dump where we are told all the basics of the Knight's Order and the hero's father instead of being shown all that through the plot.
Because fuck effort.
Sixth minute and the hero uses double standards once again, as he wants a normal life on one hand but can't stop himself from always running to save a girl in danger. Yeah man, I fully understand your drama. It's so hard having to save chicks all the time. All the beta males who are self-inserting as you can fully understand how scary such a thing is. Also, only the girls are in need of rescuing, and every other male besides the protagonist is a bully and an asshole. We couldn't allow the other way around, that would be gay. So in case a boy is mistreated by a girl, don't do anything. Seventh minute and the show makes sure we know females are ungrateful bitches who hate you even when you save them. That totally excuses why you are still alone and miserable despite your good intentions, right there in the basement. That is also the only way the show can remain a cock-teasing harem and not turn into loli porn. Eighth minute and we get some over-obsessed girl looking for the hero with a horse that for some reason also looks like a girl when they talk to each other. And to top that, they nag while in chibi mode. Just in case we don't get that it's supposed to be funny. Which by the way it isn't. Ninth minute and the first girl the protagonist saved is looking for him as well. He takes off his mask and lance and hides them behind his back, and that somehow makes him unrecognizable, even though he is still wearing the exact same clothes, has the exact same voice, and you can clearly see what he is hiding. 12th minute and the girl decides to invite the protagonist for dinner, even though she just met him and she doesn't think he is the hero who saved her, essentially putting herself in danger twice in the same episode for the convenience of the plot. 13th minute and now they are already sleeping together, just so the maid can come in the room and have lots of done-to-death misunderstanding jokes we see in harems. Having a mansion filled only with women and no parents around is only adding fuel to the fire. 14th minute and we get more narrated info dump about the girl's family, although it could be easily monologued by anyone in the mansion. 17th minute and criminals invade the mansion, conveniently at the time when the protagonist is there by pure luck. And of course they need to be evil men, mistreating defenseless girls, so the protagonist can interfere.
We couldn't have it any other way.
Also, the mansion is completely unguarded, essentially putting the little girl in danger thrice in the same episode for the convenience of the plot. 18th minute and the hero fights them back and easily defeats them by transforming into his heroic persona. That is supposed to make us cheer for him, but we can't because it's a predictable and boring piece of shit we have seen thousands of times over the years. 22nd minute and the end credits roll, showing mostly the girls and not the protagonist, once again confirming that you are supposed to self-insert as him and drool all over them.
This show is awful. If I didn't know better, I would think it's a light novel. Oh snap, it is! How are these things getting published? Anyone can do a better job. Hell, I can do a better job.
Shameless self-plug.